Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Alright, in this video we're going to sign up for a host. In our case we're going to use Bluehost because they're awesome, but you could sign up for any hosting here, whichever you prefer, and then jump to the next video after this where we actually connect our FTP details to Dreamweaver and upload our site. So if you're looking to host, okay, go to bluehost.com/track/BYOL. A couple of things happen is that you get a discount and I get a commission on the sale. Doesn't cost you anything, actually you save money, but if you don't want to do that way, you can just go straight to bluehost.com and go around my little link. Regardless of how you do it, you end up here. You click on Get Started. And what you want is this first option, okay? Have a read through, have a little look, but for the majority of small to medium businesses, you only need a simple basic plan. Okay, and it said $3.95, but actually it ends up being about $5.95 after you put all the things you need. Okay, so if you have a domain name already, type it in there. If you don't have one, I'm going to sign up for one now. Okay, bringyourlaptopisawesome.com. All right, so fill in the fields here, and this part here is really important. So your price for $3.95 is for 3 years. If you want to keep the cost down and do 12 months, you pay more, but you only have to cough up 1 year. Things you don't need: domain privacy doesn't really keep you private, only keeps you private from people that don't know what they're doing. Site backup, if you're just working on your own site, you don't need this because you'll always have a copy on your laptop. But if you're working with multiple people, this can be really helpful because they wreck your site, you don't have a copy of that new site. You want to go to this backup. I don't need it for this case because it's just me working. The search engine jumpstart never works. Site lock, okay, this doesn't work either. It just allows you to put a badge on your site to say we've secured it from malware. We're not going to use it, so we're not going to add it. And SSL certificates, a little bit complicated for what we're doing now, but it's definitely something in your future. Okay, it makes your website from HTTP, www.bringyourlaptopisawesome, to HTTPS, which is more secure, but there are some other hoops to jump around. So we're going to turn that off and keep it simple. Okay, so enter your payment details and I'll see you in the next screen. Okay, congratulations, we've signed up. Do I want payment sphere and something else? WordPress? No thanks. Okay, it'll ask you to sign up for a password. I've done that. Login. Okay, so this is where we end up. And what we're looking for, all we really need is something called the FTP details. They are a little button here. Okay, or you'll get an email like I did. Okay, welcome you to Bluehost and they'll send you the FTP information. So have a look in your email, and this stuff here is quite important. So write it down somewhere where you keep all, you know, that notebook, you keep all your files or that Google Doc. Okay, so put them all in there because this FTP details you'll use once and forget. And then in a couple of years when you need to update stuff, you'll forget, especially your password. If you do forget, you can actually find this stuff here in Bluehost. Click on FTP and right down the bottom will be that same information. I don't want to click on it now just because it has some personal details in there that I don't want you to see. So let's jump into Dreamweaver now and put in this FTP details. Okay, so it doesn't matter really what page you have open. It doesn't matter at all. Let's go to Site and Manage Site. And this is the one we're working on this whole course. Okay, Dan's awesome portfolio. We're going to double click it. And this is the details we started off putting in, but now we need to insert something called the server. That's what Bluehost is giving us. They're allowing us to use their servers. So let's hit plus. Give it a name. The top here, it doesn't matter, Bluehost. Okay. If you're using GoDaddy or any other domain hosting company, you can just type in the FTP details here. It's pretty much exactly the same. So in that email, you saw I had the host name. Okay, which is actually the FTP address. Let's actually pull this up next to it. So so that's that one. The username is there. What else have we got? We've got the password, which I'll cut out. The password. Awesome. and the root directory needs to be put in. And in our case, it's public underscore HTML. That's a super common one. Nice. Now the moment of truth. We're going to hit test. Okay, hit test, and fingers crossed it works. Awesome. If it doesn't work, sometimes when you are setting up a new hosting account, it can take a little time to populate. So give it an hour, maybe two, before you start yelling at Bluehost or me. Okay, sometimes it can just take a little while to get working. The other thing you can do is that your domain name might not be registered and working yet. Okay, so byolisawesome.com might not have populated yet. And what they've done is they've given you a temporary password. See this temporary URL? Okay, this is one that you might use in the interim until your actual domain name starts working. Let's click OK. Now, if you are having problems with FTP, some of the things that can happen is you can switch this off and on, okay, passive FTP. That can sometimes fix things. The other thing that might happen if you're using a different host, it might not be called public underscore HTML, it might have a different URL. So reach out to your hosting company if you're having problems. Before you hassle them, check their FAQs. Often they'll have like how to set up in Dreamweaver and they'll tell you which bit goes where. If you're still having troubles, reach out to the hosting company. It's what you pay them for. Okay, often the online chat is an easy way to do it. Or drop a comment here on this page and I see what I can do to help. Let's hit save. Let's hit save. Let's hit done. And you ready? Okay, so you upload pages individually generally. Okay, so I've got index.html open. And over here, we're in our files panel. Okay, so this is the site that's on my local drive. You can see local view. Okay, so this is just my machine. Now what I want to do is put it. So site put, and this is going to connect it to Bluehost. Takes a long time. Okay, connecting to server, blah, blah, blah. Would you like to put dependent files? Okay, this is important. For some reason, there's a timer on this. I'm not sure why, but I've got 22 seconds to explain it. Dependent files, at the moment, we're just putting out HTML, but we've built a CSS sheet and some JavaScript and some other things and some images. They're all not part of that, okay? So dependent files are all those extra bits. So if you just want to put up the index pile, okay, you click on no. If you want to, like me, put the index file plus all the images plus all the JavaScript and all the CSS, okay, that's what we need to do. The reason they keep that separate is that, say it's a lot of images and they're big long images, see the images take the longest, HTML takes seconds to update, whereas JPEGs can be quite big. So what you do is, say just making a text change here, okay, and you change the text and just upload the HTML, so you say dependent files no, because all the images haven't changed, they're all the same. All right, so we've uploaded it all. So now we're gonna go check Bring Your Own Laptop is Awesome. Let's go have a look in a browser. All right, here we are, www.byolisawesome.com. Hey ho, we have a website and the rest of the planet can see it. No longer testing locally or testing on our remote, and it all looks awesome and it all works. If you've got to this point, you are probably super happy with yourself. I have done this a million times and I am only doing this for a test and I'm still pretty excited. I don't know why, it feels different when the world can see it. Okay, let's go and have a look at what else we need to do just to make sure it's all up. Jump back into Dreamweaver. So what we need to do now is we need to make sure all the pages are updated. So we could now, because we've only got one of the page, the portfolio page, we can just open it and go to site and go to put. Okay, and that will upload it to the hosting. If you've got lots of pages, say you've updated and you've got 20 pages, you can have that closed. It doesn't matter. Okay, you can select on all the different pages in here or select the whole site. Actually, there's no need for those two to go up. The templates is just for you locally. All of the rest of these can go up. So you could like click this one, hold down command on a PC. Oh, sorry, command on a Mac or control on a PC and click two of them. Then up here, there's another way of putting. You can see put. Okay, and that will, it'll ask you about the dependent files again. And do I want dependent files? I'm gonna have to say yes, because that portfolio UI has some extra images. The trouble is that it's gonna go and upload the ones from index again. So it can be a bit of a long process. Let's go check it now. Hey ho, and let's click on our button. And there it is, and there's our big portfolio image. Ha, and it says, can you see over here? It says, hey, there's bits in here written in Lin, wouldn't you like to translate it? That's because I've got this placeholder text in here. So that'll go away when I actually put proper text in there. Thank you, Google Chrome. All right, my friends, that is the end of putting stuff up online. Now, that I know for a fact gives a lot of my students a lot of hassle. So drop me a line, leave a message to say, I couldn't make it work. What's wrong? Make sure you send me screenshots. I don't necessarily need your password, but it's good to see what your FTP name is and username is so that I can diagnose the problem. Okay, so yeah, that is the end of this one. Let's get on to the next tutorial.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also, on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.